This lecture is about BMI calculation, that why you need to calculate the BMI. Because by calculating the BMI, you would know about the health status, and then you can adjust your weight or fat distribution according to your height. And then you can manage and adopt such measures or behaviors to manage and to make normal your BMI. So for the calculation of the BMI, two formulas can be used. Like for calculation of BMI, two formulas are used. There is the metric BMI formula or imperative BMI formula. So in the previous lecture, we calculated the BMI using the metric formula. But in this lecture, we will calculate the BMI. We will find out the BMI by using the second formula, like imperative BMI formula. So for the imperial BMI formula, you must have the measurements for the two things. You must know about the weight and the height, and then multiply the weight and height with the 703. So you need the weight in units, in pounds, and you need the height in inches. And then you have to take care of the height. So let's calculate the BMI through an example. Here is an example. Which shows that Ishal is 5.5 and has a mass of 50 kg. What is her BMI? So this is the example. Let's solve this example by using this imperial BMI formula. Then you will know how you can calculate the BMI. Then, but for BMI, you need two things. You need the height of a person and you need the weight of a person. These two measurements are required before measuring the BMI. Okay, now let's first make the statement from this example question. Like Ishal is 5.5 and mass of 50 kg, which means that the weight of the Ishal is 50 kg and the height is 5.5, which means that 5 feet 5 inches. But the formula of the BMI in this case is weight in pounds or height in inches square multiplied by 703. So let's match the measurements, the units. Like in the example, the weight is given in kg. Let's match the units for the formula. There is the weight in kg, but in the formula, the weight is in pounds. So these measurements, these units are different. And for the height, 5 feet, 5 inches, but in the formula, the units are inches. So what you have to do, first you have to convert these units into these units to make them calculate. Okay, so weight in pounds. So first you have to convert the weight, as the weight is provided in kg. So you have to convert the kg into pounds, and the height in feet. So first you have to convert the feet into inches. So you just have to make the similar units. You will have to make the similar units and then put them into the formula and then follow the calculations. Okay, so now first we will convert this weight. Okay, weight in pounds, we have, because we are provided with the weight in kg, and now we have to convert the kg into pounds. So the weight of the shawl given is 40 kg. But as you know, that the unit 1 kg equals to 2.2 pounds. So to convert these units into pounds, what you have to do is simply just multiply this 40 with 2.2. Because 1 kg equals to 2.2, the 40 kg will be equals to how much pounds? You just have to multiply the 40 with 2.2, then it will give you the 88 pounds. So 40 kg is equals to 88 pounds. Now you have converted the units from kg into pounds. Now it's ready for the formula. Okay. Now let's convert the height in inches, because we are provided the height in feet. So we have to convert all these units similar. So height the height of the shawl given here is 5 feet 5 inches. So what you have to do, as 1 feet contains the 12 inches. Now then simply just multiply the 5 with the 12. Then these feet will be converted into inches. So 5 multiplied by 12, it gives you the 60. So 60, and then add the remaining 5, then it will become 65 inches. So it means that the 5 feet, same measurements. Now we got the measurements having the same units as provided in the formula. Now we got the weight in 88 pounds, as 40 kg equals to 88 pounds. Now we have the similar units as according to the formula, and we got the height in inches as 65 inches like in the formula. Now let's put these measurements into the formula. like BMI equals to 88 pounds divided by 65 inches multiplied by 703. So what you have to do is the square, so square of the height. Now 6 square means that you have to multiply 2 times the 65. Now multiply 65 2 times, 65 multiplied by 65, it gives the result 4,225 square. Okay, and then inches square. Now 88, you have to divide simply 88 divided by 4,225. Now it by dividing the 88 with this unit, it gives you the result of 0.02 pounds per inch square. Now you have to multiply this result as you get it from by dividing the pounds by the height, like you have divided the weight to the height. Now you have to multiply these units with the 703. Now what will be the BMI of the shawl? Now you get the BMI of the shawl is 15 pounds per inch square. Now what it means that the BMI of the shawl is 15. Now you have measured the BMI, we get the BMI. Now we have to see in which category the BMI of the shawl falls. So we have the different categories of the BMI. Now we have the measurement of the BMI. Now we have to check the health status of the shawl, that in which category she falls. So as we have different categories, underweight, normal weight, overweight, and obese. So as the shawl has the 15 BMI, so it means that she falls in the underweight category, because for the underweight, the BMI is less than 18. So it means that the shawl is underweight and she must have to adopt such measures and manage her health or weight to make them into the normal range, because the normal or the ideal or the healthy weight, for the healthy weight, the BMI should range between 19 to 24, but she falls in the underweight category. Now she must have to put some weight and to adopt such measures or to make changes in the diet or the lifestyle to make them manage into the ideal and to the healthy state. So you can also track your health if you want to manage your health. What you have to do is you have to track your BMI on regular basis, like just on monthly basis or